What's up, YouTube? So, the job for the day is, got this plate heating stand that has a water leak in it. Kind of tearing it down to inspect it. A little bit about these. They're used in HVAC systems, chiller plants, like the one we're in. And basically what they do is they can, they facilitate transferring heat from one water source to another. So let's say domestic hot water, as opposed to just taking city water that's maybe 55, 60 degrees, having to heat that with a water heater to 140 degrees, that's a long distance. And from 60 to 140, it's a lot of BTUs of heat required, especially when you're talking about large volumes of water. It's very expensive to heat that water. So, you know, in a chiller plant like this, there's a lot of heat that's being absorbed from one place, rejected, maybe to the outside. So as opposed to rejecting that and just wasting it, why wouldn't we take some of that heat, route it through the plate heating chamber, and then run our city water through the other side of the plate heating chamber? That way that 60 degree water can now absorb some of the heat from the waste heat water stream. And let's say we can bring that water temp up to, I don't know, 80, 85 degrees as opposed to 60. So now we'll only be heating 85 degree water up to 140 versus say 55 or 60. So that's the purpose of a plate heater chamber. So these are very beneficial for a large commercial building that has a lot of processes such as this building. So, the problem is, that's one of these things to do. Alright, that's loud. So, what we need to do, we need to get this thing back online where we can use it. Basically, it's been valved off because of the leak. Ideally, we want to get it repaired so we can put it back in service. What I've done is I've taken the bolts off one end of the plate here. Actually, two steel plates that kind of compress the thin plates together to create a nice tight seal. So a lot of these are what they call a cross-flow heat exchanger. You have like an X-flow. You have one water stream going one direction, one water stream going the other. The water never mixes though. It's separated by thin metal plates. So the heat can actually be readily transferred through the metal plate to the other water stream. Ideally, we don't want water streams mixing. We don't want ruptured plates. That would be a problem. So our goal today is I'm going to go ahead and pull this end mill off. I'm going to demonstrate to you what this looks like.
Here, so you can see
kind of what these plates look like here. So, there we have it. I've got my hands full. Probably should have had some help doing this. Nevertheless, that's the goal here is going to be to go ahead and remove all these plates one at a time. See if we can find the damage where we have the leak. So should be interesting. All right, all the plates have been removed. As you can see, we have gasket. And see these thin plates here. These are actual passages, water passages, that you see grooved into the plate here. So, wow, those air compressors are loud. So anyway, so this is the frame. We call that a plate and frame heat exchanger. This is the frame that it's built upon. And as you can see, we got four holes. Those represent pipes. So, come over here. We can see. See if these pipes are labeled. I think they are. Hot water supply, hot water return. And got domestic cold water in now. So, cold water is on the right side if we're looking from this side. Hot water on the left. So what we're going to do here is we're going to take waste heat from this hot water, run it through the heat exchanger on one side, and it's going to warm up the cold domestic water so that we can use that for domestic hot water for this facility. And that's a big energy saver, so it's a pretty big deal. It's pretty important that we get this thing back online and running. But there you see the Victaulic fittings. Kind of have this thing together. There we go. All right, so consider yourself educated on plate frame heat exchangers, their purpose, and how to disassemble them for inspection. And I think this is going to be a job for another day because it's getting near the end of this day. So anyway, hope you enjoy the film.